What's up, guys? Welcome back to another EVE Online Fit video. We're going to be going over the Trig battleship, the Leshek, today. This is going to be a solo fit. I will do a group paired up fit whenever I get a alt kind of trained into that, so you can kind of see how that works. What I'll do is I'll go over the fit that I use for a solo on this, and then I'll go over the implants that I use for this. It is kind of implant heavy, and then I'll kind of just run through like a simple rally point, just kind of show you how the rotation works and kind of how it works out in space. All right, just go over this fit stuff real quick. We'll start the high slot. So I use a Valis Entropic Disintegrator here. The faction just works a little bit better. And then I have a 52 fall off range and a 52 kilometer optimal range. A lot of this is helped out by the implants and everything like that. So the ammo you're gonna be using here is gonna be Mystic for your long range, and then Occult for your short range. And Occult, I think, is at like 21 kilometers or so. So you'll be switching out between Mystic and Occult based on like the range of which the targets you're targeting up. For the rigs, I use large Trimark Armor Pump 2s. A little pricey, but they help with just overall tank and everything. For the mid slots, we're going to be using a Republic Fleet large cap battery just for more cap, because it's really cap intensive on this fit. And then a 100 mm Afterburner 2. Just to allow us to have a little bit more speed for a little bit of SIG tanking that will be going on. And then we'll be using 2 Imperial Navy capper chargers also to help with our cap on this. For the lows, I'm using Imperial Navy 1600 millimeter steel plates, 2 of them. And then for the solo fit, like I said, Imperial Navy large armor repair. This is going to be your localized armor repair, basically your lifeline. And then using 2 multi-spectrum energized membranes. And then we're using 2 entropic radiation sinks with a damage control. You can run a faction damage control on this, but I usually don't, just because the regular Tech 2 works just fine. We'll go and throw simulate on this so you can kind of see. So we're at negative 9.7 on the cap here, but most of the time you're not going to be running the afterburner with the armor repair. So as you can see here, we're cap stable. We are running local armor repair. And also, if you're not needing armor repair and you need to like move around, you're also cap stable. If you have to run both, then you know you're not going to run out anytime soon. You're going to be like 12 minutes, 33 seconds on that, depending on your skills. And as you can see here, our defense, we're looking at about 220,000 EHP. A lot of that obviously is in our armor here, because it's an armor ship, no shields allowed. And as far as the drones go, I carry Hornet EC-300s just in case. But you also use Hornets, Vespas, and Wasp. You're going to change your drone type based on whatever rats you're fighting. But really, this is going to help with smaller ships, because you're most effective with like destroyers and up, cruisers and up, like battleships and stuff like that. Any frigate-sized things, the Disintegrator has a hard time ticking on, so I use drones to basically take care of those targets. We have our targeting range is about 108 kilometers, a little overkill for this, but it allows you to actually kind of like set up targets while you're still out of range. While doing just normal combat anomalies, you're going to warp in pretty much at zero and, you know, start orbiting and taking things out at close range. As far as skills are concerned, you definitely want to try to get the Precursor Battleship skill up as high as you can. And then under Gunnery, you also want to get your large Precursor weapon to 5, and then also your large Disintegrator weapon specialization all the way to 5 as well. Going over the implants here, I'm using a high slot Mimesis Alpha through Omega. And what this is going to be doing is going to be giving you Disintegrator cycle and damage output bonuses. And then the Omega is just going to give you an 80% bonus strength to the Mimesis implant secondary effects. And then for slot 7, I use evasive maneuvering, because there's not really anything better to put here. It just gives you a little bit more agility. And then I use capacitor management here. This gives us a 5% more capacitor, just to help out with being cap stable and things, so that we don't run out on any of that stuff. And then repair efficiency on slot 9. This will work with local armor repair, 5% repair amount. And then also I'm using the hull upgrades, which gives us more armor hit points. That's pretty much it for the fit and the implants that I use. It's pretty straightforward. We're going to go and head out to a rally point, just kind of show you damage application, and then just kind of the, you know, rotation and what you'll be doing inside of a combat anom with this, and kind of how movement and all that stuff feels like. So we'll head out and do that. All right, so whenever I warp into any of this stuff, I usually just kind of warp in at zero, and then I'll just orbit, like, you know, one of the structures or whatever. And so we're at like 50, we have a 50k range on this right now, so we can actually go ahead and just start hitting these towers, as you can see right here, and we'll be just taking these down one by one. We'll I'm gonna throw out hornets, and what these hornets are gonna do is they're basically gonna take care of these frigate size targets while we're taking care of kind of the bigger stuff. Once we start working on things that are more in within like 20k range or so, then we'll be switching to a cult. I usually always start these rally points with Mystic loaded, just so it's a little bit easier. Go and grab this other missile battery and everything. Get it targeted up. And you probably want to like adjust your warning sound and stuff for your shield, especially if you're used to running shield chips, because otherwise it's just gonna like make an annoying sound. Because with this ship, you're pretty much gonna be always at zero shield on all that. So we're gonna just kind of keep going through this. Gonna get these hornets over here on this destroyer, and we'll just go ahead and keep targeting up. Pretty simple. Once the next wave pops up, we'll find a building that's a little bit closer and start orbiting that. Go and get that down. And then get this. We're probably not going to hit this wrecker too much, but the hornets should take care of it fairly easily. Go and get this next wave up so you can kind of see. The rally points are a little low-key for this ship. Hubs are a little bit better, just because the more battleships that you have, it's going to be higher bounty rewards for it. And then also you just have better hit chance on it. And since we're orbiting this right now, we can go ahead and turn this off, and then we'll get, you know, our cap kind of set back up. This Pith Eliminator, I'm going to go ahead and approach. And then we're going to take out this cruiser first. Once this cruiser is dead, we're going to go occult and then start working on the battleships. All right, he's down. Switch occult because we're in range. We're going to go with the Eliminator here and start ticking away on him. You see that shield? And every time it rotates, every time it cycles, it's going to do a little bit more damage as long as you're on the same target. So in a couple of rotations, we're going to be well into his hull. We're going to go and switch over and start approaching the other battleship, which the drones aren't doing a whole lot of damage towards, but they're not expected to do a whole lot of damage to the battleship class rats. Turn off our afterburner. They're coming in pretty hot. Got about one more tick on him. And we just switch over. This should be it for the rally point. Once we get this guy down. Doing about 800. It goes up pretty quick. You'll be well over 1,000. Within like a couple of ticks on a target. But like I said, doing a combat anoms is fine with this ship. But I think the greatest strength for the Leshek is doing structure bashes, or anything that you can basically put the disintegrator on for a long amount of time. A lot of the structure bashes that I've gone to with the Leshek, or even I've you know gone to ones with Tempest and stuff like that, but like almost always the highest damage output for the entire structure bash is always at the very top of that kill mail is always going to be Leshek's usually. Because they can just stay on target for so long, and then they get that maximum tick, and it's just the damage output is just absolutely amazing. But hope you enjoy the video. I'll put the fit in the description so you can easily import it into game. And then, like I said, I'll do a paired Leshek video once I get my alt trained up, so you can kind of see all of that stuff. It's not a whole lot different, but there is some strategy there for actually like keeping things linked and things arranged and. We'll go over all that, but thank you for watching. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.